mother said he does it all the time. Every time he sneezes, he says Alhamdulillah. In the coma. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no one more faithful than Allah. If you are faithful to Allah, Allah is faithful to you. Allah will guard you. Sabr. So three things. What are the three things? Tawbah, shukr, sabr. Never again complain about anything. Nothing. Whatever happens, Alhamdulillah, ala kulli hal. The food is not good. Your wife cooked the food. It's not good. Alhamdulillah. How is the food? Alhamdulillah. Why? Because who is your razaq? Who is your razaq? Your wife or Allah? Who is your razaq? Your cook or Allah? Allah gave you the food. What are you complaining about? What are you complaining about? Is it possible for the cook to put more salt or less salt without the izn and hukam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is it possible? No. Alhamdulillah. Tawbah, shukr, sabr. Three things. Three more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the three surahs, first three surahs to be revealed, the first one, but the first one there is no but the first ayat, not the entire surah, but the first ayat, there is no difference of opinion. About the other two, there is a difference of opinion, which was first, which was next, but we know that all three, these three were the first three. Which are the first three? Surah Al-Alaq, where Allah said, Iqra. So I want you to remember three words, Iqra. The second one was either Muzzammil or Muddathir. So Allah says, Ya ayyuhal Muzzammil, قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. So the second word I want you to remember is قُم. And the third one is يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَّثِّرُ قُم فَأَنذِرْ. So third word is قُم. اقْرَأْ قُم قُم. Remember the three words? Now, what is the meaning of that? Allah is saying اقْرَأْ means read. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that read meant recite what is being revealed. For us, read means to read. Because you are not really receiving any revelation for us to recite. The revelation, we have to read the revelation. So read. Read means what? Get ilm. Knowledge of Islam and then other things. But get the knowledge. Read. Iqra is read. Then, kum. Kum illa 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 qalila. Stand in the night and connect with your Rabb. And then the next kum. Kum fa'anzir. Wake up in the morning, now go out and spread the word of this deen. Go and warn the people. Read, the knowledge is required for you for two things. One, the knowledge is required for you to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there is no connection with Allah without knowledge. And the knowledge is required for you to go and warn the world. For knowledge is required for you to go and take the message of this Islam to the whole world. And that is the reason why the Iqra. Iqra, kum. Get the power. Kum fa'andir. Go and tell the world about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Introduce Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the world. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduced himself to you. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? Six words. Before I go to that, six words, six things to remember. What are the six things? Tawbah, shukr, sabr, iqra, kum. Come. Yes? Go and introduce Allah to His creation, because Allah introduced Himself to you. And what did He say? He first spoke about the greatness of His kalam. And He spoke about the effect that His kalam has and should have on us. When He said, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشيا متصديا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. What did Allah say? Allah said, if this kalam, if this book was sent down on a mountain, what does it mean? Does it mean just put the book on a rock? Sent down, nuzul of the Quran on the mountain means, if the book was understood by that mountain, if the mountain understood the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what would happen to the mountain? It would humble itself to dust. Min khashyatillah. Because of the khashya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
What did Allah say about the ulama? What did Allah say about the ulama? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that from the people, the ulama are the ones who have the most khashya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاء. What is the meaning of that? The Mufassirin have said, it does not mean that every alim has khashya. It means that only the one who has khashya is an alim. Because there are ulama who have no khashya. It means that only the alim who has khashya is an alim. There was a man called Bishr al-Hafi at the time of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah alayhi. And Ahmad bin Hanbal used to call Bishr al-Hafi, he used to say, he is my sheikh. So somebody came to Imam Ahmad and said, Bishr does not remember too many hadith, he does not know too many hadith. Why do you call him your sheikh? Imam Ahmad said, he has the hasil of ilm. He has the essence of knowledge. They said, what is the essence of knowledge? He said, the essence of knowledge is khashyatullah. It's the khashya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduced himself by saying that if my kalam was sent down onto a mountain, the mountain would humble itself to dust. وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُ عَلِ النَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. And these examples we give to the people so that they will think and they will reflect. I ask myself and I remind you, my brothers, what happens to our qulub, what happens to our hearts when we read and recite the Quran? Does anything happen at all? Because if it was sent to a mountain, the mountain would have humbled itself to dust, would have become dust with the khashyat of Allah. But alhamdulillah, we have mountains in our chest where nothing happens to them. Nothing happens to them. The entire kalam of Allah can be in our heart, but nothing, no change whatsoever. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun. And then having introduced the topic of His grace and majesty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then introduced Himself, and with those ayat I close my talk today. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن مؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك فإنه لا يضل من واليت ولا يعز من عديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت نستغفرك اللهم ونتوب إليك ربي لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك يا حي الذي لا يموت يا حي الذي لا يموت يا حي الذي لا يموت أجرنا من النار يا رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبي الكريم محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.